Welcome to this week's mood board session.
Yeah, why is this dorm been closed the entire day? We just not like fresh air at all.
It's a little warm in here.
If I turn the heater on, I still have it on though.
Did you just say you turned the heater on?
Yeah, because it was cold earlier.
Was it cold in here earlier?
Yeah.
It was a bit nippy.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's heater worthy though.
It was heater worthy.
I recall you saying, let's rip the heater.
Different kind of heater, you know that. Don't bring that into this.
Direct quote.
Everybody get up, get some fresh air, get some energy.
Okay. Alright, here we go. Let's go.
Freestyle? I'll give you a beat.
I don't think I could right now. I'm out here with my team. I'm so excited to reset me.
Drop the mic.
Fire. That was fucking fire.
I could have kept going. I'm way better when I'm drunk though.
Whoa. All right, let's talk here.
Let's rip this.
Everybody will just pull out their Instagram. I think we should create, can you create like a join saved folder? No, you can't. But maybe we should use Pinterest too. So let's create a join Pinterest account. Okay. We're looking for types of content that we want to add to that will be on our Instagram. So like our Instagram theme is gonna be something like a mix of go on Instagram and type in the good trade. Theirs is kind of like super wellness,
right?
Like neutral tones, white, like simple and like earthy and like friendly and just like warm, you know?
Yeah.
Very wellnessy. So if that's on one end of the spectrum. If you go to like Hypebeast is like street and like still, Hypebeast is like elegant, but it's like street and like dope. Somewhere in between all of those is us. Welcome to the Shark Tank. All right, we are starting to do this in our house where we are going to review some of the products that we did try or that we do use on a regular basis or things that we try out and sample. We're gonna talk about them. We're gonna go over like the packaging, the branding, what we like about it, what our thoughts are, our honest thoughts.
These are our honest opinions. They're not for, it doesn't mean for everyone they feel this way, but this is how we feel. And we wanted to give you guys an intro into every week the brands we work with or that we get to try and what we think about them.
Here we go. A prey. All right, so a prey is a plant-based shake. They call it protein-based replenishment. It's a plant-based shake.
I love shakes like this because it's so easy. Like
Yeah, today we have one. Super easy.
You just grab it.
I like the packaging on these with the marble effect. It's very different than you traditionally see with a health and wellness company or a supplement company. Three different flavors, vanilla, cold brew coffee, and
sea salt chocolate.
So we're gonna test them out. You go and then I'll try it.
The salt's actually stronger than you think, but I like it.
Initially, unreal taste. There's definitely some sort of aftertaste. Is it the salt?
I think it's the salt.
Might be the salt. But I will say, for a plant-based shake, bomb.
Vanilla's always my favorite. That's bomb.
Yeah, vanilla's just 100.
I love the way JT tries things. He takes a very good
job. We're moving on. Okay, the final for today is 101 Cider House. Some sour cider, cactus rosé. Here we go. There you go, sir. Cool, so tell them about the drink.
Okay, so 101 Cider is really cool because it actually has, it's like made with juice, but it's a cider, so it's supposed to be like helping you not hurt, how do I say this? Supposed to be not hurting yourself as much with a pressed juice. It has 100% pressed juice in it, non-GMO, all that great stuff, but it's still cider, so it doesn't have all those bad shenanigans in it, and it's made with juice, so you don't, I don't know. When I drank them at the party, I loved them.
Yeah, it says there's antioxidants and vitamins in it. It's gluten free.
Zero sugar.
Keto friendly. Vegan. There's probiotics. Says it's 100% pressed juice. Only 84 calories. Alcohol. I mean.
There's actually another flavor too, but we ran out of those. It's called Sunlit, which that one was.
Let's just drink.
That one was lit. Cheers. Big fan.
To me, it tastes like kombucha with alcohol in it.
It does. It tastes a little bit like kombucha.
But it's interesting though. It's not. It doesn't. It tastes less like cider. It tastes more like kombucha.
Yeah, agree.
But I like it.
And the packaging, I think, is cute.
Yeah, this one and the other packaging is cool too.
But yeah, it's sunlit, so it's like a sunset.
101 cider.
All right, we're gonna cheers to that.
Okay, so we're talking about morning routine, and we're talking about the importance of having a morning routine.
Yes.
Why don't you start and tell us what you think is the reason why it's so important to have one?
I think that it's super important to have a morning routine because when you wake up, you set the tone of your day. And I think throughout the day, a lot of things can trigger you. So if you can have somewhat of some control of the first 30 minutes of your day, I think is a game changer for how the rest of your day can go. So for me, it's super important to not digest anything that isn't positive or uplifting or inspirational or anything that is gonna bring negative vibes, I don't wanna be a part of in the first 30 minutes. That involves me not checking my phone and me only not even replying to texts, speaking to anyone besides you, obviously, about anything until I feel like I have got, I'm in the right mindset to further my day for whatever comes at me.
I think the importance of having a morning routine gives you control over the day. It sets the tone for it, and it's, again, before anything throws you off, which obviously there is, it's inevitable for things to happen throughout the day that shift your energy or shift like how you're feeling. The morning routine that you have at least gives you a head start and a leg up on all those things that are gonna come your way.
Have you always had a morning routine, or do you think that you had times where you didn't have one and now you see the importance of it?
There have been times where I didn't do a morning routine, where I just kind of winged it, and I think that is probably the times where I've felt the most flustered. Having a morning routine always makes me feel like I have control over the day. Like it feels like, it just feels like you start with a win, you wake up, you meditate, that's already giving you like, fuck yeah, I did that. I might have not wanted to do that in the morning, but I woke up and I sat down and I took 10 minutes to myself, and now like after that 10 minutes I feel good, I feel like I've accomplished something. Then go on a walk, that's another thing that you've already done that's added on to the way that you're going into the day. And by the time that you sit down at your desk to start your work, you've already accomplished a handful of things.
Yeah, that
totally
feels really great.
It does. High four takeaway.
Someone you leave behind, I'll break your heart so you don't break mine. For I love you, nah, 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 I'm gonna leave you, nah, nah, nah. Even if I am not here to stay, I still want your heart.
What's up, guys? We're back with some Reset Fuel. We're talking about what we're eating, what we're doing, how we're fueling our bodies with nutrition, with the foods that we're eating, with the smoothies, the things that we're drinking, everything that's going on in the kitchen we're sharing with you. So today we're gonna do a super simple meal that I do a lot for lunch or for dinner. This is just a simple option. Everything that we have in this meal is bought at Trader Joe's. Should take a total of 15 minutes to put together, and we're gonna show you how it's done. So here we go. You know it's foreign, I'm so foreign. Then you see my girl, you know she foreign. I'm in Lauren. You've been wearing Tommy, got it foreign. You so boring. All right, so here we got some chicken that is already marinated. This is chicken breast that's gonna be on the grill, along with the zucchini that's gonna be on the grill. We're gonna cut this up, season it a tiny bit, and throw it on the grill. And then we got some rice medley for our carb. This is gonna be easily thrown in the microwave, and together it's gonna make a whole meal that'll be cooked in about 15 minutes, ready to go, full of nutrients, full of what you need for the day. It's gonna be good. We're about to throw these on the grill, so we're gonna put all of the zucchini into tinfoil wrap, season it a little bit, and then throw it on the grill. I got my handy assistant right here with me. All right, give it a little spray.
That form, that technique.
Very nice form, right? Have another piece, make a little tinfoil cave, and that's good to go on the grill. All right, if you guys want to follow me out to the grill, should be ready now. So we're gonna take the tinfoil, grill medium high. Should look pretty nice. And just toss her on, a zucchini. Get this chicken going here, I'll just toss a couple on like that. Pull it to the back here, medium high heat. Oh, that's gonna be a big guy. Oh yeah. It's hard to mess up anything on a grill, I'll tell you right now. Look at how good that looks. It's fantastic, I love the grill. And then we'll close it. So I'll leave it here. We'll come back and check on it in about, it's medium high heat, I'll come back and check on it in about 4 or 5 minutes. Chicken, it depends how thick the pieces are, but chicken cooks pretty quick if it's not super thick. So I'll come back, these are pretty thinly sliced, so we'll come back and look at it in about 3 minutes, 3 or 4 minutes. And then flip it, and it'll take a couple minutes on the other side, and then you're good to go, brother. It's that easy. Obviously, I'm a pretty advanced chef, but for all of you beginners at home, you could probably do something like this.
Yeah.
Maybe not to the same extent,
yeah, but... Keyword, probably.
How's this look? How's that look on camera?
Oh, dude, it looks like I'm filming for Food Network channel right now.
Yep.
Test it.
Sam's gonna test the meal and we'll see what she thinks.
So good. Honestly, freaking delicious.
It's good stuff.
That chicken is so good. That seasoning, like, delicious.
I knew it was good before, but I didn't know it was that good.
Just all around a great meal. This is very easy, very simple. And we'll probably save a lot for later.
Yep.
Delish. Go work.
Try it. Alright guys, thank you for watching. Please try this at home. As you saw, this is such an easy thing to do. Took a total of about 12 minutes from start to finish. Now we're eating good. We'll have some leftovers. Let us know if you try it. Let us know if you tried something like this. And let us know what you guys want to see.
Let us know.
Smash that like button.
Hit us up.
Smash that subscribe.